So this is the meaning of life in 5 minutes. Okay, first thing, step one, define meaning of life. So there are two ways to define meaning of life. The first one is that the meaning of life is the meaning of all life. It's like asking the question, why is life on Earth? So I'm not going to answer that in this video. What I am going to answer is the other way to define meaning in life. What is the meaning of an individual's life? What is the meaning of my life? What is the meaning of your life? And most importantly, are there any common elements, or we might call universal elements, between everybody's life meanings that could point us to some sort of theory to the meaning of life? So the first thing we need to do if we're going to have a theory for the meaning of life is we need to show that nihilism is false. And how do we do that? Well, there's this man, his name was Friedrich Nietzsche. He was not a nihilist, although Crash Course says he is. I love Crash Course, but they're wrong about this. Nietzsche was an anti-nihilist. He discovered this growth of nihilism that corresponded with the reduction of Western religion and Western spirituality, because when people were turning away from religion, they were turning to nihilism. And Nietzsche saw that as a problem. And so Nietzsche developed the solution to nihilism. What Nietzsche did was he said that whoever escapes from nihilism is a Superman. Super is translated to German as above. And so someone who's an above person is someone who's able to transcend above the meaninglessness of everyday mundane things without the imposed requirement by religion of there being a higher realm or a higher spiritual realm. And so the point of Nietzsche was that the person who escapes from nihilism does so by going deep into their own lives and deep into the earth and finding meaning there in the tangible, real things in their lives. The objection to that is, oh, come on, that doesn't really show that there's meaning of life. That just shows that people are mentally satisfied with this illusion called their life meaning. But Nietzsche would respond to that if they feel as if their life is meaningful, then by definition, God damn it, is meaningful. Okay, so I have 2 minutes to explain what the meaning of life is. And thankfully, I'm not the one who thought this up. I'm taking this from other philosophers. They did all the work for me. I'm just telling it to you. So, remember earlier in this video, I said, well, maybe we can find a common element between everybody's meaning in life, and we can call that a universal property, and we can use those universal properties to construct a theory for the meaning of life. Consequentialism. Okay, it's a metaethical theory that states that whatever is good is that which leads to the best consequences, never mind what good consequences are. That's up for debate. Very hot topic. But anyways, so the meaning of life, according to consequentialism, would be a life that leads to the good consequences for the most amount of people in the long term. And if someone can do that, then they've led a good life. So what are good consequences then? Well, according to a utilitarianist, a good consequence would be one which maximizes positive experience and minimizes negative experience for the most amount of people in the long term. Okay, that was a mouthful. But keep in mind that these are theories of the meaning of life, which means they're not just for me, they're not just for you, they're for everybody, that anybody who wants a meaningful life needs to abide by this theory. Now, as one might imagine, this is a highly controversial and debatable and contentious topic. Not only because there are multiple competing theories about what good is, like virtue theory, which was Aristotle's and Socrates' theory, but also because a lot of people will insist that there are no universal properties among the meaning of life. This is called subjectivism. But then critics will argue that meaning has to be objective, at least to some degree, because it just can't come from nowhere. And if it's emerging from something, that something should be controlled by the universal laws of nature, just like anything else. That was the meaning of life in 5 minutes. Please subscribe for more content.